Morning, day 113 in our series 2 to 5, and this morning I am, well, I'm not able to hear, now I am, thank you, working on that exposure change issue that we had yesterday. I did get that little plug-in that was like $3, it's okay, but I don't know, because you're dealing with like a frame by frame level, I don't know if it's just too tedious for me, or if I'm not doing something right, I'm just not quite getting the results that I wanted. So I'm gonna keep playing with it and see if there's anything I can do to, I don't know, try and make it work, I guess. It's, man, it's a struggle to try and figure out, because it just changes, like, literally it'll change, like, 4 or 5 times within the span of 2 seconds, 3 seconds, and you don't know exactly, you know, what's changing, and it shifts a little bit just in terms of what, you know, what colors and stuff each frame, and it's just really, really tedious to try and match up one frame with the next when the variations are so slight. They're obvious enough to where you notice it when it plays through, but when you're flipping back and forth between two frames and trying to match up the colors, God, what a nightmare. So I'm going to try that. I'm going to try to see if I can do some compositing too. What I did try this morning, which I thought was kind of genius, but it didn't really work out. I thought, okay, well, what I'm going to do is try and pull all the color out of it, just completely desaturate it. So basically you have just black and white. And then I'm going to try and match the color from another frame to this one to see if it somehow, you know, pulled in all the colors, but this time it would pull them in consistently across the shot, and that didn't work. It just looked like somebody pissed all over the frame, because it was just all yellow. And I'm like, well, not quite the effect that I was looking for. Was consistent. It was consistent piss right across it, which that, I mean, I did ask for consistency, so thank you. But, yeah. So, again, I'm going to keep playing with it and see what I can figure out here. There's got to be an easier way than doing it frame by frame. Has to be. Right? All right, well, not a very productive morning, quite honestly. I've tried several different things, and I'm just not able to crack this shifting exposure code, that little plug-in. I don't know if it's not that I don't know how to use it, it's just literally you're gonna have to go frame by frame to correct it, and it's just I'm not exactly sure what I need to correct, if it's just a moving of the exposure, or if it's the saturation, or if it's a little, it literally almost has to be perfect, otherwise you're gonna notice these shifts all the way throughout. I've tried to chop the scene up, or the shot up, and basically, so if, like, say you had one shot, but I chopped it up into 4 shots, and then I said, okay, match this shot with all 3 of these other ones, and it didn't work. The shift is obvious enough to where you'll see it as you play it through, but it's not so obvious, it's too subtle apparently for it to recognize, for Final Cut Pro to recognize the little nuances in there, because you can still see the shifts as you play it through. It's super frustrating to try and to figure that out, and like I said, this is one where, you know, I might be able to get away with just not having that person shown if it was a shot. But there's like, four or five different times that I cut to them, and a couple of them are fine where there's no movement, so it doesn't really matter. It's just when there's movement within the frame that it's immediately trying to adjust. So at least probably three of them, I'm gonna have to figure out something on this. So, and two, you can't really, I mean, there's plenty of effects that you can put in in Final Cut, but they're like, I don't know, like special effects type thing to make them look, more aged, or certain flashes or grains or that sort of thing that you can't really use. You're just trying to get it authentic. So yeah, I'm still struggling with this. I may shelve it for a day or two and see if I can come back to it, or I may keep trying to figure it out. My brain is spinning trying to figure out certain workarounds. I might look up some things on the internet too to see if there's any other solutions out there. But punishing, man, and I'm being punished for lock the exposure. It's 101 shit. But anyway, I won't do that again. So anyway, thanks for joining. I appreciate it as I struggle through this, and I will see you tomorrow, 2 o'clock.